Internet Lifestyle Nightmare, a horror story. This is the story of how an internet lifestyle dream turned into a nightmare. Long, long ago, actually not that long ago, about 2 years ago, I had a dream. The dream of building an automated internet business where I could buy a system, push a button, and millions will jump out of my computer. But here is the warning. Caveat emptor, let the buyer beware. When you have a dream, the marketplace is there with a solution, and not one solution, but many solutions that will make your dreams instantly come true. And oh boy, did I sell these solutions to myself, and did I spend money buying them. Affiliate programs, product launches, lead generation systems, MLMs, the dream was fueled by all the marketing and training material provided. Just take massive action. Boy, did I take action. Massive, useless action. As Jim Rohn so eloquently stated, if you motivate an idiot, you get a motivated idiot. I have to confess, I was a very motivated idiot. In reality, this comes down to the sad fact that if you take massive action in the wrong direction, you get there very quickly indeed, but even worse, if you do not correct these actions, it leads to misery. So here's what the internet nightmare looks like. Maybe someone can relate. The 124-hour plus work week, yes, I read the 4-hour work week. Spending a small fortune on push-button software. Jumping from opportunity to opportunity looking for the holy grail. Spending a fortune on advertising, every possible idea, name it, I have the t-shirt. Actually building a list and then trying to sell to them, creating no sustainable relationship with them. Creating social media pages to advertise my products. Checking email every 7 seconds. The 7 second rule. If I don't click on my email every 7 seconds, I will miss something important. Creating a number of blogs and writing hundreds of blog posts to promote all these opportunities, etc, etc, etc. The real effect with this nightmare was that I spent all my time in front of my computer trying to dig myself out of a hole, while actually digging the hole deeper. My lifestyle was a shambles. I actually did all this while running another business. I had no time to spend with my family. My lifestyle was not healthy at all, sitting in front of a computer day and night drinking coffee. And worst of all, hoping, dreaming that things would change. Reality check. Nothing will change unless I change. I knew this, heard it many times, but this is the problem with a dream. In its nature, it blinds you to reality, and if you keep dreaming, you never smell the coffee. I slowly realized, very slowly, remember I was a motivated idiot, that I am not checking my dream against reality. Now this is strange for me because in my real world business, I'm a hard skeptic and would never make a mistake like this, but a dream is powerful and can blind any skepticism because really a dream like this is a wish for what we really want. Now I'm not saying that we cannot get what we really want, but to get what we want, we need a realistic plan. A dream is a shortcut for the lazy person inside each of us. So slowly the dream became a nightmare until one day something saved me. No, not some software code I discovered embedded in the pages of The Secret. A program like this might be a bestseller. No, what saved me is that I am a reader. Yes, I have always read, and through all this, even though I read much less than I used to, every now and then I read something. And one day I read Rich Sheffrin's Internet Business Manifesto, and it got me thinking. Fortunately, it's still legal to think, and when I really started to think about it, I realised what an amazing idiot I have been. Yes, a very motivated one. I finally saw that I acted like an opportunity seeker online, and not like an entrepreneur. My dream shattered because it was flawed. I dreamt of the easy life, like the buyer of every lottery ticket. This is what the opportunity seeker dreams of, easy money. Whereas the entrepreneur dreams of building a business, the opportunity seeker is just that, a seeker and consumer of opportunities. The entrepreneur is the creator of opportunity. Realizing my fatal flaw, I immediately proceeded in blaming the marketplace, the guru scammers, all the fake opportunities, all the hype. I was furious. How could they sell all this junk to innocent people like me? I'm going to go to the FTC, etc. I will get them. They will pay. Yes, pay for robbing me of my dream. And just like that, my dream reinstated itself. This time, though, I was saved again by my reading, because when you read a lot, you tend to think a lot, and this makes you self-aware. After I calmed down a bit, thought a bit, I finally realized it is not the gurus, the sellers of products, the marketplace, they are just marketers doing their job. It is me. I am the fake. I am the scam. I am the opportunity seeker, the motivated idiot. It's all me. And for things to change, I have to change. Wow, I must admit that really rocked me a bit. Caveat emptor, let the buyer beware of the dream he sells himself. But I finally had the basis to change my behaviour by realising that I had to challenge my dream. I had to look at my online business as a business. I had to create a vision for a business, and as soon as I did this, things began to change. My vision, helping myself and others to work where we want, when we want, with whom we want, whilst contributing to society. In short, total freedom. If you are interested in me helping you to create total freedom, click the link below this video.